Jay. Here's the Halloween decorations you wanted.
Oh, cool. Thanks, man.
Funny, very funny.
Now we're gonna go in the kitchen and scare the guy washing the dishes.
You were right, Fidel. He was terrified.
Oh, man, here we go again. Another Halloween with Vidal and the stupid tricks. Come on, man, we were just having fun. No harm done.
Wake up, Simone! Oh, I tell you, Halloween used to be great fun back in England.
What'd you guys used to do?
Well, first of all, we pick one house in the street and put toilet paper in all the trees.
We did that.
Then we get the shaving cream and cover all the windows.
We did that too.
Then we cut the head off a cow, put it on a broomstick and parade it through the village square. Gotcha!
You're doing good at this.
Hey, guys, what's so funny?
Oh, we just played a few Halloween tricks on old Jeff here.
Yeah, and they were hilarious. I can't stop laughing.
You don't like Halloween?
No, see, I like the cute kids in the costumes. I like the pumpkins. I like the candies. But I just don't like those stupid tricks. You know, I just don't like surprises.
Mm-hmm, I'm with you, darling.
So aren't you going... Miss Paige, not you, too.
Oh, come on, Jeff. Where's your Halloween spirit? You know, we got this party coming up. Are you bringing anyone?
No, I haven't asked anybody yet.
Good, because my stockbroker, Andrea, came by the club the other night, and she thinks you're cute. So she wants to meet you. She'll be stopping by any minute now.
Oh, Miss Pacey, I wish you had to ask me first. See, I don't go out on blind dates.
It's not a blind date. I know what you both look like.
No, see, you don't know what type of girls I like to go out with. They've got to be funny, sweet, elegant, and romantic.
I have a list, too. Female and breathing.
When did you get so picky?
What's wrong with one blind date?
No, I just told you guys I don't like surprises. I like things to be planned out.
That's no fun, Jeff.
Well, Charisse, we know Jeff is not exactly Mr. Spontaneous. You guys ought to check out his planning book. He's got stuff in there like 315, scratch forehead.
Okay, you guys may think it's stupid, but every time I don't follow my plan, I live to regret it.
Okay, that's great. But what am I supposed to tell Andrea?
Well, Miss Page, you're going to have to tell her thanks, but no thanks.
Hey, Chelsea!
Andrea!
Well, the least I can do is meet her.
You feel like having fun after your day is done.
Working too hard, beating fast.
You're the mic, pulling out of the mix. Baby, you wanna get fixed.
Come on down to Chelsea's car. Oh, where the music is hot.
Andrea Faison,
mm-hmm.
Meet Jeffrey Carswell.
Hi, Jeff. Nice to meet you.
Same here. You know, as soon as Miss Page told me you were dropping by, I said, cool, I'm with it.
Okay, I'll let you two talk. I'll see you later.
All right.
Okay. Bye-bye.
Well, Charisse, romance is in the air, and I'm waiting for my Halloween treat. And you're looking mighty good and plenty. Sugar.
But, doll, don't you ever stop.
I don't like to brag, baby, but you're not the first woman to ask me that. That's right. Run on home and take that cold shower.
Jeff and Andrea make such a sweet couple, don't you think?
Nah, I was just saying that to get Charisse in the mood. They're not right for each other.
What do you mean?
Well, look at the way she's dressed. That's strike one. She dresses like my dad. Well, my dad with a real nice booty.
You know, that's a really nice outfit you have on.
Oh, really? Thanks. Just my work clothes. And I'm a lot more comfortable in some beat-up old sweats.
Strike two. She's not elegant. I know my boy. These two have nothing in common.
I mean, my idea of a good time is just hanging around the house with the TV on, watching football.
Wait, you like football too? I like football.
Who's your team?
The New York Giants.
Oh, you know, it's really nice to see Sales back in there. Nothing against Hostetler now. I mean, he's great in the pocket, but he just can't throw the long ball.
Strike three, that's it. Chatterbox. The boy can't get a word in edgewise. Jeff hates that.
You know, I can listen to you talk about sports for hours.
He's just being polite, Angus. That girl is out of here. Well, you know him better than anybody. Pity, though. Yeah, it just wasn't meant to be, Angus. I've seen it happen before. Uh-oh. He's about to drop her, man. Don't look. This is not going to be pretty.
So are you free for dinner tonight?
Sure. You pick the restaurant.
Okay.
Are you good?
Well, you have to come over and find out.
Ooh, that's an offer we can't refuse. Wanna walk me to my car?
Sure.
Oh, that was gruesome. I'm sorry I had to witness that.
Hey, Jeff.
Yes, sir.
What's that I smell? Lobster tail? On the first date? What are you gonna do for the second date? Take it to France?
I just wanna make a good impression, man.
Well, you're doing it all wrong. You gotta leave something to work up to. That's why I thought up the V-Man dealer meal dating plan. First date, burger. Second date, chicken. Third date, she gets her own bag of fries. And if she wants the extra biscuit, you know what that means, Jack.
I get the door.
Mm-hmm.
Get the door.
Hi, Miss Chelsea.
Hi, Vidal.
Gotta run. I promised Siobhan that I'd plan our trick-or-treating route.
Where are you gonna go?
I'm gonna get a map of the Stars homes. I heard that Ed McMahon is giving out junkies.
Hi, Jeff.
Hey.
You know what? After I gave you the tablecloth, I found these napkins that go with it.
Thank you, sir.
So how did your dinner turn out? Did my recipe tell?
They sure did.
What's this?
Oh, that's amaretto peach cobbler.
I thought you were going to use my pecan pie recipe.
Oh, well, see, I changed my mind. See, I wanted something just a little more special.
Oh. Well, my Nana Hattie thought it was special when she passed it down to Grandma Nora. Grandma Nora thought it was special when she passed it down to Mama. Mama must have thought it was special when she passed it down to me. But I understand if it's not special enough for you.
I'll get that.
How you doing, Jeff?
Hey, Charisse, what's up?
Charisse, baby, come here and look at this little cobbler Jeff prepared. Now, isn't this special? Mom, you should have given him the recipe for your pecan pie. Huh? Anyway, Jeff, here's a serving set you wanted.
Oh, cool. Hey, these are like new.
They are new.
Charisse, did you buy these for me?
No, I've had them for about 5 years.
5 years?
Yeah.
Don't you ever have anybody over for dinner?
That's none of your business, Jeff. Come on, baby. Let me make you a little treat. Nothing special. Just a little pecan pie.
Oh, hi, hi, Chelsea.
Hey. Hey, girl. Tell me something. Do you like pecan pie?
Sure.
Yeah.
Oh, what a shame. Come on, baby.
Hey, Andrea. Come on in.
Wow, Jeff, everything looks so elegant.
Thanks.
You sure went through a lot of trouble.
Nah, I just threw this stuff together.
Oh, Jeff, you made this?
Oh, come on, it's nothing special.
Peach cobbler.
Amaretto peach cobbler.
With spoon, with...
No, you're gonna spoil your dinner.
Mm-mm. This smells so great, you gotta try some.
Come on. Nah, I'm gonna spoil my appetite.
Come on, just loosen up, baby.
Andrea, nobody eats dessert first.
Jeff. Take a walk on the wild side. There you go. Now, how was it?
Okay, it was needs more nutmeg.
You know what I mean.
Okay, it was good.
Oh, good.
Did I say it was good? What I meant to say was that was the best damn cobbler I've ate. No, I have never had a cobbler quite like that cobbler.
Oh,
woo, that was some slamming cobbler. I think one of the things that got me into music was my mother singing around the house all the time. She sang when she was driving us to school. She sang when she got home from work. She sang us to sleep.
Oh, that's really sweet.
No, actually, she had the worst voice you ever heard in your life. You know, but I loved hearing it. I mean, every time I hear a song from the 70s, or Nails Across the Chalkboard, I think of mine.
Oh, you. A little dessert appetizer, you just loosen right up, don't you?
Nah, I'm just having fun.
Oh, me too.
Hey, listen, you know, we're having a Halloween party at the club. Do you want to come with me?
I'd love to. What are you going to wear?
I don't plan that far ahead. I just know what I'm going to be doing now.
What?
This.
Thanks for coming by to meet the kids, Harold. Come on in and have a seat.
Oh, come on, Chelsea. You know I'm too legit to sit.
You know, I appreciate this. And I know you want to rest up before the show tonight.
It's no problem, eh? It's for the kids. Bring them on.
Well, please, Sam, don't hurt them. All right, everyone. A special friend stopped by to wish us all a happy Halloween. Are you ready?
Yeah!
Surprise, surprise, surprise. It's Hammer.
Happy Halloween, kids.
You're not Hammer.
What do you mean I'm not Hammer? Of course I'm Hammer.
You don't dress like Hammer. Hammer dressed like this.
Yeah, I used to dress like that. I dress like that when I'm on stage, but right now I'm just chilling.
Yeah, right.
Hey, look, I can prove I'm Hammer. Here's my driver license. Look right here.
It doesn't say Hammer. It says Sally Burrell.
Blowout style and all that. Look, if I wasn't Hammer, could I do this?
Please.
I'm getting mad. Stand back. Give me back up a little bit, man. Give me some go hammer gold or something. Hold on, what you say now?
Whoa, you're even better than Hammer.
Come on, Chelsea, help me out.
I'm afraid you're on your own, Stanley. Come on,
get up. Excuse me, Mr. Hammer. I've got my cab outside. You'd like to lift back to your hotel?
Proper.
No, not really. The accent just makes me sound that way.
Hi, guys. I just missed Hammer.
Oh, I forgot.
You should put these things in your appointment book, dear.
Yeah, you're right. Have you seen it? I don't know where I put it.
You mean you've been living without an appointment book?
Yeah, that's right, Miss Page. I've been living on the edge, and I like it.
Jeff, I really gotta get back to work.
Hey, can't you wait another 30 minutes?
No, she can't, darling. She's handling my money.
Don't worry, Chelsea. I'm on my way.
Okay, give me a kiss.
All right. Yo, Jeff, need to talk, man.
Hey, break it down for me, B.
I'm a little worried about you, man. I woke up this morning and the sink was full of dirty dishes. Now, that's not like you.
Oh, yeah, man. You're right. I'm sorry, man. Thanks for doing it for me.
I didn't say I did them. I said they were there.
All right, man. This is more to life than dirty dishes.
Uh-oh. Somebody's going off the deep end.
Man, no, I'm not.
Well, I hope not.
Look, B, thanks for having my back, man, but I have everything under control. Man, I am telling you, Andrea, she is just so special. And tonight, I'm going to ask you to be my lady.
You mean you're not going to date anyone else?
No, I don't see any reason to.
What if she gets a cold?
But, dog, I can wait 4 days.
I couldn't.
Well, B, it seems to me that you've been waiting for...
Hey. Now, this ain't about me.
Come on, B, man, you're supposed to be my boy. I thought you'd be happy for me.
I'm happy for you. I'm happy, man. I'm just worried about one thing.
What?
If you two get married, where are we all gonna live?
You know, the moment I saw you, I said,
Now there's a woman who's an original. A woman who's one of a kind. Meow.
Oh, Miss Paige, that's a nice costume.
Oh, thank you, Jeff. You know, this Halloween, I decided I was going to keep it a little simple.
Hey, the doll.
Oh, baby, if you're the mermaid, I'm Jacques Cousteau.
James Dean costume.
No, I'm not James Dean.
Oh, yeah, Charisse, he's, young Elvis.
No, I'm not him either.
And then who are you supposed to be?
I'm the guy of 90210.
All right, everybody, here he is. And believe me, it really is. The one, the only, Hammer!
Body pumper, it's setting up good, and then let go. Part and me, I'm begging your pardon, but it feels like starting something. Now that the music has got me moving, come on baby and let's get into the party. Before we get left out, a little bit of time, yo, and we'll turn it out. Like it this way. Can I get a no, a yes, or a yay, yay, good? Cause I do refuse to ever give you something that you cannot use. Dance and express yourself. Mix and mingle and jump to the left or right. It's going on tonight. Get in the momentum and I'm getting hype. Yeah.
Get in momentum.
And pump her up loud and play up with her homies in front of to the crowd. Merry, merry, nothing ordinary. Music guns and it's very style.
Yeah.
But it still gets in them. You can't stop it because it's gaining momentum.
Gaining momentum.
Jumping. I told you that I felt like starting something. Pump up, stomp up, make your body jump up. Fuck the glass door when your life is gonna blow up. Moving and grooving, that's what we're doing. Nothing negative because your mind will be ruined. Aim for the top and go straight up in them. And never let them stop you when you're gaining momentum. Yeah.
Gaining momentum.
Know you had the softest hands?
Oh, thank you. That's sweet.
So, Andrea.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Man. Now, you've heard something over and over and over again, but until it's time to say it, it's like... Okay, I'm just gonna say it, all right?
Okay.
Now, I know we've only been together for a few days now. See, a lot of people spend their whole lives looking for the few days that we've just spent. I just want you to know that I've never met anyone else like you before. and I don't want to see anybody else but you.
Hold on, Jeff. I'm not ready for this. Jeff, you're a really great guy, and it's been an incredible few days, but it's just too much too soon.
Okay.
I mean, I just came off a really serious relationship, and I'm not ready for another one.
Well, we can slow down.
No, that's not it. That's not it. Jeff, I really care for you, and you've already shown me how you feel about me, but right now, I just don't feel the same way. I wish I did. I guess I better go now.
Yo, Jay, that party was all that.
Uh-huh.
Did you see those honeys in those Catwoman outfits? Now I know why Batman returned.
No, I can't believe I let these dishes pile up like this, man. You're right, V. You said I was moving too fast. She didn't feel the same way about me.
I see. You know, any other time I'd be glad I was right. But this is one time I wish I was wrong.
See, I knew I shouldn't have gone out with her. This is why I don't like buying dates. See, I'm telling you, V, every time I don't follow my plan, I live to regret.
You'll be all right.
You know what, man? I wish I was more like you sometimes.
What do you mean?
I mean, when a girl says no to you, it doesn't even faze you.
It's no big deal.
No, I'm serious, man. It's amazing. I mean, the slap mark hasn't even faded from your face yet, and you're on to the next one.
No pain, no gain.
Girl after girl after girl after girl.
Okay, Jeff, you made your point.
Sorry, man. And I guess my problem is when I fall for someone, I fall too fast.
Jeff, didn't you just finish telling me earlier today that this was the best week of your life?
Yeah.
Well, if you had played it safe, the best week of your life would have never happened.
You know, for a brother who spends hours trying to figure out why Fred won't give Barney any Fruity Pebbles, you can get pretty deep.
Just think about it. The brother's been living next door to him for 2 million years, and he won't even give him a bowl of cereal? Come on, man, it's Halloween, and the night is still young. Now, I know you like to stick to your plans, but you think you could stand a little surprise in your life?
What'd you have in mind?
Well, we'll go down to the pool hall, we'll shoot some pool, grab something to eat, and just hang.
That's cool, but what's the surprise?
I'm paying.
Hey?